Hello and welcome to the 8th lecture in this lecture series on international investment law. In the last video, we discussed the concept of investment and analyzed two different types of the definition of investment, taking the India-UAE BIT and the Brazil-India BIT as examples. We also saw the general practices regarding the definition of investment. In this video, we'll discuss the ICSID practice and the Salini test. Article 25(1) of the ICSID Convention states, the jurisdiction of the center shall extend to any legal dispute arising directly out of an investment between a contracting state or any constituent, subdivision or agency of a contracting state designated to the center by that state and a national of another contracting state which the parties to the dispute consent in writing to submit to the center. When the parties have given their consent, no party may withdraw its consent unilaterally. Thus, as per this provision, ICSID will have jurisdiction to a legal dispute provided it arises out of an investment between a contracting state and a national of another contracting state and consent is granted. It is important to note that ICSID jurisdiction will get attracted only if there is an investment as per Article 25. Even if there is an investment as per the concerned BIT or investment treaty. This is what is known as the double barrel test or the double keyhole test. Investment has two aspects to it. The contribution that constitutes the investment. This is the focus of Article 25 of the ICSID Convention. And the rights and value that derive from that contribution. This is the focus of the definition of investment in the investment treaties. There has been some dilution in this recently with the tribunals leaning in towards the definition of investment as per the BIT. Readers may refer to Selin's article titled Ablakat and Others versus Argentine Republic, the definition of investment in the ICSID review. We saw in the previous lecture that majority of the BITs define investment. Unfortunately, the ICSID Convention does not define the term investment, although ICSID tribunals have held that this is a threshold requirement and parties cannot even waive this requirement by consent. Owing to the lack of definition, we have to rely on decisions by the tribunals on the issue. The leading decision on the point is by an arbitral tribunal in the case of Salini Constructori versus the Kingdom of Morocco, which was decided on 23 July 2001. The Salini test was propounded by a three-member ICSID tribunal in its 16-page decision on jurisdiction in a dispute between Salini and Morocco that arose out of a construction deal. Morocco raised several jurisdictional objections in the dispute, including the objection that there was no investment as per the BIT and the ICSID Convention. Morocco contended that the breaches alleged were mere contractual breaches and not violation of the BIT. The tribunal, after considering the arguments of the parties, held at outset that in order to attract the jurisdiction of ICSID Convention, the claimant should satisfy the twin requirement that the investment concerned was an investment as per the BIT as well as Article 25 of the ICSID Convention. For instance, in 1985, the Secretary General of the ICSID refused a reference in a dispute emanating out of sale of goods in the case of Asian Express versus Greater Colombo Economic Commission. This is reported in the ICSID Annual Report of 1985. Readers may recollect that previous lecture where we discussed the wider asset-based definition of investment and the narrower enterprise-based definition. The Morocco-Italy BIT of 1990, under which this arbitration was invoked in the Salini matter, contained a wider asset-based definition. We also discussed in the previous lecture that the asset-based definitions usually consisted of two parts. The first part defined investment and the second part provided a non-exhaustive list of what constituted investment. The Salini tribunal found that there was an investment as per the BIT at least under two items of the non-exhaustive list. While dealing with the requirement under Article 25 of the ICSID Convention, the tribunal stated, the doctrine generally considers that investment infers contribution, a certain duration of performance of the contract, and a participation in the risks of the transaction. In reading the convention's preamble, one may add the contribution to the economic development of the host state of the investment as an additional condition. Thus, according to the tribunal, the following criteria were relevant. 1. Contributions. 2. A certain duration of performance of the contract. And 3. A participation in the risks of the transaction. The Salini tribunal also held that if the ICSID convention's preamble is read, contribution to the economic development of the host state of the investment was an additional condition under Article 25 of the ICSID convention. Note that in listing out these criteria, the tribunal was recounting what the doctrine and the preamble to the ICSID convention stated. Thereafter, the tribunal went on to analyze these four criteria. It said, in reality, these various elements may be interdependent. Thus, the risk of the transaction may depend on the contributions and the duration of performance of the contract. As a result, these various criteria should be assessed globally, even if, for the sake of reasoning, the tribunal considers the same individually here. On facts, the tribunal in the case found that the Italian claimants contributed in money, in kind and in industry. The transaction contract duration was for 36 years, and to satisfy the requirement of the doctrine that the minimum length of the time should be 2 to 5 years. The claimants undertook risk. In fact, a construction that stretched for many years, wherein the total cost could not be established with certainty in advance, created an obvious risk for the claimants. The claimants were able to provide the host state with the know-how in relation to the work. Further, in most countries, construction of highways fell under tasks to be carried out by that state. It could not be seriously questioned that the highway in issue was to serve public interest. On the basis of the above findings, the tribunal considered that the investment in question satisfied both the BAT as well as the ICSID convention. Please note that the tribunal itself diluted the requirement of contribution to economic development to one of public interest. So, what happened after Salini? Salini test is considered to be the leading test on determination of investment under the ICSID convention. However, not all tribunals have completely followed the test. Some tribunals, of course, have followed the test. But some tribunals have increased the threshold of economic development criteria by stating that there must be significant contribution to the economic development of the host state. An example is the decision in Joy Mining versus Egypt. At times, tribunals have removed the economic development criteria. For instance, the Quiborax versus Bolivia tribunals. Tribunals have at times added other criteria. For instance, the tribunal in Phoenix action versus Czech Republic has laid down the additional criteria that assets must be invested in the host state in a bona fide manner. The tribunal in this case laid down the following criteria: a contribution in money or other assets, a certain duration, an element of risk, an operation made in order to develop an economic activity in the host state, assets invested in accordance with the laws of the host state, and asset invested bona fide. So these criteria form the decision of the tribunal in Phoenix action versus Czech Republic decided on 15th April 2009. There are also instances where certain tribunals have rejected the Salini test. In fact, in some cases, even the non-ICSID tribunals have applied the Salini test, although the Salini test was propounded in the context of Article 25 of the ICSID Convention. To sum up, in the previous lecture, we discussed the definition of investment under the BITs, where we saw that primarily there were two kinds of definitions. One, asset-based definition, and the other, enterprise-based definition. In this lecture, we discussed the definition from the perspective of the ICSID convention. We also discussed in detail the decision on jurisdiction in Salini versus Morocco, where the Salini test was propounded to expound the requirement of investment in Article 25. We also dealt with how later tribunals have employed the Salini test. A detailed assessment of the definition of investment as per different tribunals is beyond the scope of this introductory course. However, those interested in knowing more on the topic may access the innumerable articles written on the topic, including the following references. Bridget Stern's article titled The Contours of Notion of Protected Investment, published in the ICSID Review. Then Celine's article titled Ablakat and Others versus Argentine Republic, The Definition of Investment, published in the ICSID Review. Those watching this video may also refer to an older publication by OECD titled Definition of Investor in and Investment in International Investment Agreements, published in OECD's International Investment Law, Understanding, Concepts and Tracking Innovations. There is also a recent article by Kan Yeginsu and Saida Nobel titled Covered Investment, published in the Investment Treaty Arbitration Review, published in 2018. This completes our discussion on the definition of investment. Bye and stay safe.